Fernandez puts up a three. It's good. 2-point game. Timeout, United States, as Spain storms back.
Bryan on the drive. Tough shot. Gets it to go. Out to Wade. His three-pointer knocks it down.
August 24th, 2008, where they responded to incredible game pressure.
Kobe Bryant from downtown.
And then how they showed reverence toward the game, how they handled everything. I saw at that moment the respect of the world. And they won in a way that won a lot more than that gold medal. I've been involved with USA Basketball since I started as a head coach. It's been almost 30 years. I've been fortunate enough to be in some of the game's greatest moments and be associated with some of the great players and championships that have been won. And so when Jerry Colangelo took over as managing director and then he chose me as the head coach, I jumped at that opportunity. The idea was to develop a program, to work on a culture. Every player who was selected understood that they were going to be one of 12 and that all 12 were important. We had a great feeling for who we were representing. It wasn't the Lakers or the Cavaliers or whatever. By the time our guys hit the court, they knew they were playing for the United States of America. They're all amazing character guys, in addition to having a great deal of talent. And I respect them immensely. The putting of gold medals around my neck and Colangelo's neck and the assistants. We didn't expect that. But you know what? We probably should have, because that's the type of guys they were. The Olympics for me were the most incredible professional experience I've had. You know, I was with great coaches, Jim Boeheim, Mike D'Antoni, Nate McMillan. On a day-to-day basis, just listening to how they prepare, going through practice plans, implementing a system, different terminologies, different ways that they would approach it, you pick things up. Then we had the relationships with the players, so we asked for their input. So they gave us their input on how to defend, things that they liked offensively. And you learn from getting their input. You also learn from them on how they prepare. What else do they do besides just practice? And then to have my staff there with Steve Wojciechowski and Chris Collins, they were doing that while they were working with the team. Well, I think our players have benefited greatly from the fact that we've worked with the Olympic team. I've had to tell them at different times, look, I love working with you, and I don't expect you to be Kobe Bryant. Now, can you be pro players? Yes, you can. I need to connect with these guys at their level using the knowledge that I gained from the Olympic team. And it's exciting because it's new. And so it invigorates you, and that's the way I think we are as a staff right now, very invigorated and with even better knowledge than we would have had if we hadn't gone through that experience. Getting involved means you owe the game. And that's the way that the people who love this game the most have felt over the years, and that's why the game has grown. And so we all have a responsibility to give back to the game. I love the fact that so many Duke players have participated on U.S. teams. That's the idea that you want to have perpetuate to the younger kids who are playing in those youth games. And, you know, then the under-19 championships, the university games, and so that they grow not just as basketball players, but they grow in their love for playing for the United States, and it becomes a way of life. How beautiful is that?
Team USA gets it done.
But that's what you call hard work paying off. Right there.
Thanks, guys. Thank you. Oh, I just got your
phone. That's all right.
Thanks, Joe. Whoa! Thanks, you.
Great
turn. Tell us one.
Thank you, guys. Thank you, man.
Yeah!